Now when working with contacts in the Contacts app, most of the time when you add a new card, you're going to enter a first and last name. This makes sense, but there are going to be times when there isn't a name associated with a contact. Think about it. You would have contacts like, say, your cable company or your power company, something like that. Something where it's a customer service line and there's no individual person that's associated with that contact. It's just a company. So you can not enter a first and last name, but instead a company name. Of course, the actual name of your cable company would go there. And you can click this company button right here, which will actually put the company name at the top. It still leaves spot for the first and last name. So say if you have a specific person you talk to, maybe it's your insurance company, for instance, and there is an agent that you usually talk to, but you don't really think of that person's name when you want to call them. You want to do it by the name of the company. So you can still put the first and last name there, but it comes secondary. Just as the name of the company would come secondary during a normal contact. And the cool thing is when you use it this way, the name of the company is now listed here on the left. It would be listed anyway if you left the first and last name blank. But it makes a lot more sense in your list of contacts. Plus, you can actually use Siri and actually use that name there. It syncs with your iPhone and everything like that over iCloud. So you can say, call insurance company, and it would actually use this contact. Or you can also use it when sending an email. You can start typing insurance company and it will fill in the email address there. It won't expect a name. So it's very handy to do. I make sure in my real contacts that I've got the customer service lines for all of the major services that I use around the house and things like that. So I've got my bank in there. I've got insurance companies. I've got power company, telecommunications, everything like that. And it's all set to be a company contact rather than a individual's contact. And without editing a contact, you can actually go to card and you can go mark as person or mark as company. It's command backslash, so you can change it there. And you can also put an image for a company just as you could an individual. So for instance, you can quickly go to the website for the company and say this was their website, and you can drag and drop the company logo in and it will actually put it there. So when you get a phone call from them or you're looking through your contacts on your iPhone or whatever, you can see a image there just as you could with a regular person.